On Monday, April 8th, 2024, there will be a solar eclipse. That means the moon will pass directly in front of the sun from our point of view. In Virginia, we can look forward to a partial eclipse. Some portion of the sun will be covered by the moon between 2 o'clock and 4:15 p.m. At the eclipse's peak at 3:19 here in Richmond, about 83% of the sun will be covered. Meanwhile, parts of the United States will enjoy a total eclipse, where, for a few minutes, 100% of the sun will be covered by the moon. And this is only visible from a narrow band about 120 miles wide called the Path of Totality. It stretches from Texas up through the eastern Great Lakes and through northern New England. Now, why do solar eclipses happen? The moon is really small, about 400 times smaller than the sun, but it's also about 400 times closer to the Earth. So when the moon moves directly between the Earth and the sun, it can block the sun out entirely. Even though a portion of the sun will be covered, it's really important that you don't look directly at the sun during the eclipse. But there are ways to observe this phenomena safely. You can use certified solar eclipse glasses, or look for a solar viewer, a small car that has the same solar filter material embedded in it. These devices look pretty simple, but they're designed specifically for directly observing the sun. In either case, you want to make sure that they are marked with ISO certification 12312-2. Make sure the numbers are in that exact order. That'll make sure you're safe, because regular sunglasses are not safe for observing a solar eclipse. You can also use a telescope if you have a solar filter over the end where light enters the telescope. You want to make sure the filter is designed specifically to fit your model of telescope and follow all manufacturer recommendations to make sure it is installed correctly. And don't forget about cameras, phones, or binoculars. They'll need filters too. Anytime you observe the sun using a device that concentrates light, you need a solar filter to avoid damaging the equipment or damaging your eyes. If you can't get solar eclipse glasses or solar filters, you can still observe the eclipse indirectly. It can be as simple as looking at the shadow of a tree, where you'll see the crescent shape of the partially eclipsed sun as the image filters through the tree's leaves. If you're feeling crafty, you can build your own viewer that works in a similar way. Click the link in this video to see how to build an eclipse viewer using common household materials. Remember, on April 8th, please don't look at the sun without proper eye protection. Use solar eclipse glasses, a solar filter, or try an indirect viewing method. Happy eclipse watching, science lovers!